Introducing hereditary curriculum in classroom teaching is a bit complex in the lower grade levels. So when I am dealing the ninth class children for this, generally what I do, basically what are the requirement for the basic knowledge regarding the hereditary, I just share them by using PowerPoint presentation or the videos which I made personally. So after that I just make them the group, and we have made a teaching learning material in such a way that they just go through those documents, and in the interactive session, that's what we generally consider it as a flipped classroom. Generally I give them all the stuff to their students, what they are dealing, and generally they just go through that stuff when they come to the classes again. So during the class hours, what we do, we interact with each others in a activity based thing. So to conduct the activity, the real necessary materials have been already made, and it is available to the children on net as well as offline also in their respective computer rooms and all these things. So when they just get together, the introduction of typical words like genes, hereditary, inheritance, all these things, they just go learn with the different tasks and activities. And here the each and every individual in the class, they involve, because they will be made into different groups, and all these groups are being assigned different tasks according to that. So what, some people they'll just learn by the game based method, some people just make by the experience, some people by sharing. Here what happens, the whole classroom is really make it live learning process, where we can just say that the learning takes place in enjoyable activity based learning, and at that same time generally they will also talk about the different tasks which are involved in that particular content, and they learn that particular topic also based on that particular end. So here we have made all the classes, whole class into four groups, and we have been assigned different tasks depending upon their traits. And they first, they invent their traits by the survey method. They have been given worksheets. According to that, they'll just themselves, they'll identify whether they are having such traits or not. Once they have identified those traits, these traits will be segregated individual level as well as the group level, and they will be making in the, they will be identifying their group, their traits, as well as their friends, colleague traits, in which way normally we can find out which trait is more abundant, which we see among these individuals. They can very clearly justify themselves, and they can be developed into a different graph, pictorial form, like a family tree, risk disorders which are there, running inheritance through the family. All these things, they just make it everything, and they can also distinguish which is a trait and which is a tradition, because we have a lot of things in involving in this learning the traits what they have. So they have the very knowledge of discriminating which is right and which is wrong, and all these children, they construct that particular, what we can say, a class trait tree based on the traits which they have in their which are inheriting in that particular manner. So when we just meet, they'll make an activity, they'll remember all the contents and all the stuff which is learned through this process. Here what happens, there is a method of collaboration, there is a method of communication, there is a building of leadership qualities, there is a effective critical thinking. Means we can just inculcate by conducting this activity, the whole 21st century learning skills can be integrated in this manner. So this is this schedule, this teaching learning material is available on net, and the students can download it at any moment. They review these videos which was shooted during their learning activity time period, so they can also self-assess themselves how they actively involved in that, whether the involvement is a passive or active involvement. And here you can see that all the students Together they are making a graph which is normally an integration of mathematics into this biology curriculum topic. So we have also looked into the multidisciplinary way, and we have allowed the children to explore as many as subjects in this particular topic, which is the introductory part of hereditary to the age. So here they can very clearly distinguish that the number of blue dots, which indicates their traits present in the male, and white dots present in the females, and the abundance of the trait which they can see in this.